Okay, so we're going to recap, and then we're going to vote. So, The Fabulous.
Broken Mirror.
Blood on My Pillow.
Okay. So please vote by applause only for The Fabulous.
Broken Mirror.
Blood on My Pillow.
We now present the completely improvised film, Blood on My Pillow, with opening credit music by David Norfleet.
Talk to you about your wife's test results. Let me get you some chairs.
Thank you.
Thank you, doctor.
We had an office party in here last night. My apologies.
I know how office parties can get, doctor.
Honey, sit down. Dr. Peterson, why don't you just give it to us? We're a little nervous. What is that we're looking at, Doctor?
Those are the CAT scans of your wife's nose. She has rhinitis.
Hold on, honey, hold on. Doctor, could you please tell us what that means? We don't know.
The blood that you found on your wife's pillow.
Yes.
Is caused by acute rhinitis. I'm afraid, Mr. and Mrs. Davis, it's quite fatal.
What does that mean, Doctor? Quite fatal. What does that mean?
Your wife will be quite dead in a short period.
Doctor, quit saying the word quite. Please don't say quite again.
If you'd like some time alone, I understand.
We would, thank you.
I'm sorry, this champagne bottle.
Perhaps you should get a cleaning person.
I apologize.
Good, thank you for apologizing. Sorry, but they should take a class on how to treat people when they're giving them bad news. Oh, fuck that.
Who cares about that?
Honey. Listen, we didn't get a lot of detail there. I don't know what... Some people have illnesses for a long time and they're doing fine. Okay? He said quite, but we don't know what that means. Maybe you'll live 40 years. We'll get more detail later, honey. I'll talk to him on the way out. You don't need a doctor.
Gary, I'm going to die.
No, honey, we're all going to...
I'm going to die soon, I know.
Don't say that.
We've only been married a year.
I know that. Honey, it was just a little blood. It wasn't a lot of blood.
I know, but it was blood night after night until I went to the doctor, and now I have rhinitis.
God damn party hats.
Damn it. I was so happy. I've been so happy this last year.
I'm so by, honey. For the first time in my life, I've been happy. Do you remember how I waited so long to marry you? What a fucking idiot I am. I should have married you the day we met.
No,
I should have.
You wanted to wait until you could afford a wife. Until you could buy a house and we could plan for a family.
Take care of you. So nothing bad would ever happen to you. Right?
Why don't you go talk to the doctor and get the details and I'll...
You gonna be okay here?
Yeah, I'll just clean myself
up. Are you sure?
Yeah, Gary. Go on.
It's a piece of cake. You made me laugh.
No, Kim, come on, try the icing. Maybe
it's... It's good.
Have some. I'll go talk to Dr. Pearson. Right. I love you.
I love you too, Gary.
I do.
I'll be back in a minute.
Okay.
Excuse me, nurse. Excuse me, I'm looking for Dr. Peterson's office.
Oh, it's over that way. Right. Second door on the right.
Second door on the right, right down this corridor?
Yes.
All right.
He can be a little difficult with the patients. We've talked to him about it, so.
Good, keep talking.
All right.
Hello? Dr. Peterson?
Yes, I'll come down in just a moment.
Can I come in?
Yes, why don't you come in? I'm upstairs here in my loft in my office. Up here, Mr. Davis.
Oh.
My office is quite large.
I see you up there.
There's some stairs there if you'd like to come up.
Wow. Big room?
Yes. I'm sorry. I just wanted to say I'm sorry about your wife's diagnosis. You seem like you're very much in love.
I am. Thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm sorry I yelled at you. You must get a lot of that.
I do. It's part of my job. No one likes to give news like that.
Doctor, what does quite mean? Quite fatal? Can you put a time on that for me, please?
I can. A week. If I'd used the word week, it would have scared your wife, so I used quite instead. It's not much better, but...
What do you mean a week? Definitely a week? At the maximum a week?
Yes. At the maximum a week.
How is that possible? A problem with your nose can kill you in a week or less.
No one knows.
Is that a joke, you bastard? Because if it is, I'm gonna punch you. No one knows?
No. No, I promise I wasn't making a joke. It was already out of my mouth. By the time it was, I realized it may have been construed that way.
How long did he say?
He said...
He said... Say it. A week. He said a week! It doesn't mean anything, a week. What do doctors know? They're wrong all the time. They're like weather forecasters.
Mom, Dad, I'm going to practice.
Tommy! Have fun. Have a good practice.
Okay.
Tommy!
What, Dad?
We love you. Say you love him, honey.
Gross.
Gary. Gary, you can't fool me. We've only been married a year.
I know that, honey. Quit saying that, please.
We haven't started a family yet.
I know we haven't. I know. We're gonna have our own kids, honey, all right?
Did you invite that neighbor boy to be our boy?
Yes. Yes, I did.
Gotta go.
Hold on.
Get out of here. Thank you, Mom and Dad.
You don't have to say that anymore. He's actually not even a boy. He's 22. He's just short. Yeah, you make me laugh even though I only have a week to live.
Good.
But you've given me an idea.
What?
Let's find a child, a real child, to adopt. You know that ex-girlfriend of yours, the one who works at that adoption agency? Couldn't you contact her, say we want to do an expedited adoption? That it's very important that we get one in the next couple of days. Maybe we could go in and we could
talk to some children, and I can help you pick the child that will be our child. And then when I'm gone, you'll have something left.
All right, honey, all right. I'll call Belinda. I'll see if we can get over there this afternoon, all right?
All right. And Gary, I think it's sweet and very silly of you to get that neighbor man to do that.
Adoption agency.
Hello, is Belinda there?
This is Belinda.
Oh.
Gary?
Yes, it's me, Gary, huh? Belinda?
Hi. Why are you calling here? What a surprise.
I have something unusual to ask you, Belinda.
Well, go ahead.
I can't hear you very well. Is something over the mouthpiece of the phone?
Oh, yes. It's my hair. Just a moment.
Oh, you're crazy.
Excuse me, Belinda. Do you know where the jump ropes are?
Yeah. They're in the chest over there.
All right, thanks.
Thanks, Luke.
Sure.
Your hair's so long, huh?
Yes. Sorry it was in the way of the receiver.
That's all right. Anyway, this is unusual, I know, but can my wife and I come over this afternoon to take a look at adopting a baby?
Of course.
Or a kid. It doesn't have to be a baby. It doesn't matter.
Okay, we have both.
You do? Do you have any that you've had for a while? You've had a hard time placing them?
Well, yeah. There's a few.
Oh, good.
I mean,
we're looking to adopt right away.
Well, there's all sorts of paperwork, Gary. Just a
Belinda. Donnie's gotten into the jump rope chest.
Look, Gary, I've got to go.
All right.
We have a troubled kid.
Okay, we're going to come right over. We'll be there in maybe 20 minutes, all right?
20 minutes?
Yeah.
All right.
Okay, thanks, Belinda.
Bye.
Bye.
Coming, Luke.
Hurry up, Linda. Donnie kid is out of control.
Here we go, honey. We're here. Honey, you know, or you might remember, that Belinda and I used to...
Of course, okay. I remember
right.
that.
Okay.
A woman doesn't forget things like that.
All right.
They stay in her mind forever.
Okay. I'm sorry.
It's all right.
I wouldn't have said anything, except I don't... God, you look pretty.
Well, enjoy it while you've got it.
Come on, let's go in.
Hey, wait!
What the hell?
Hey, kid! Hey! Hey, you! What the?
Jesus Christ. Look at that.
Oh, he bashed out one of the headlights.
Fuck.
That's Belinda, honey. Belinda! Belinda!
Gary. Hi.
Who's that little hellion you're chasing?
Oh, he's just Donnie. He's a troubled youth. Please, welcome.
This is my wife. You remember?
Of course.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
Belinda, we're
ready to look at whoever you were talking about when I called.
Oh. All right.
Won't you come in?
Yes, please.
Oh, Gary, I left a handkerchief in the car. Could you get it for me? I might need it. It's on the seat.
Sure. I'll be right back.
Belinda.
Yes?
May I speak to you for a moment?
Certainly. Won't you come in?
Why don't we just talk right here while we have the moment?
All right.
I have to say, I've always been jealous of your previous relationship with Gary.
Oh, please.
Don't talk. Let me finish before he gets back here. I've just been diagnosed with a very deadly illness. I'll probably be dead within a week.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I am so sorry.
I know you are.
You're just newly married.
It's been a year now. I just want to adopt the baby for this last week so that after I'm gone, Gary will have something. Some part of me will still be there in its own way. And I really appreciate anything you can do to expedite this.
Of course, of course. Anything I can do.
What I'd like to do is when we leave here, I'd like to leave with a child today. I know it can't happen. I understand. But
I'll see what I can do. I must ask you a question.
I'm back.
Gary,
we were just having a little girl talk.
I couldn't find a handkerchief, honey. You must have it.
Oh, it's in my purse.
Oh, all right.
I didn't know that. You have beautiful hair.
Thank you. Well, I need to clarify something. You each have asked at different times for a child and a baby, and I need to know which it is.
I want a child, one that can walk and talk.
Child, it is. Whatever she wants.
We don't have time for it to grow up. Gary, I took the time to tell Belinda the whole truth.
Please, come in. Let's not stand out here. I have to be quite frank with the both of you that in order to expedite, I would have to most likely offer you a child who's been here the longest. I mean, those are the rules. I can only do so much.
Fine. I understand.
We just want someone we can take today, if that's possible. I can have my lawyer come over and do all the paperwork.
If you'd like, I can send somebody in.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you, Belinda. I really appreciate this.
I'll do what I can. Just stay here. There's a book that's open with the faces of all the children that are available, but I'm afraid. Just a moment. Hello?
Hello. Hello, he's on the loose again.
All right.
Running around the facility.
All right, Luke, just do whatever you have to do, but...
Belinda, you know I hate that kid. You've got to get out of here as quick as you can.
All right.
Okay, thanks.
Bye. Sorry. Right. I'm going to put this on mute. Once and for all. I'll be right back.
Let's look at the faces of some of the kids, like Belinda said, honey, just in case.
I think she said those are ones we can't have.
You want to look at their faces anyway? Pass the time together?
Sure.
Stand close to me, honey.
All right. Oh, look at that one. It's lost a tooth.
Look at that.
Little gap tooth.
I remember when I lost teeth. Doesn't keep you from smiling when you're a kid, does it?
No, hardly anything keeps you from smiling when you're a kid.
How about this guy here? Look at that. Look at that crazy nose. It's so big.
Oh, look at the freckles on that one.
Look at those. They're huge.
Hey, look at that one. That one looks...
Hey! That's a little brat that knocked out our... headlight on the car. I'm gonna go see it.
Guys, I've done my best. Look, I'm trying to arrange a meeting with you and Donnie. He's been here longest, and he's a wonderful
kid.
Can
you show me a picture of Donnie in this book, please? It's on the last page.
Oh, yes. We've met him. Twice now.
Did you say met him?
Yes, he broke out headlight on our car. And just now he came in and
gave us a double bird.
Just now, you say?
Yes.
He
just came in through those double doors and then ran off.
If you'll excuse me.
Honey, I don't know. You're under enough stress already. This kid is...
I want a child, Gary.
This kid is out of control, honey. We don't need that around the house, do we? I mean, he's...
We don't have much choice.
Hey, you. Kid, what's your name?
Donnie. What's your name? Fucker. Nice to meet you, Mr. Fucker.
It's not.
Oh, no?
Fucker.
Sure looks like it. Are you Dr. Fucker? Or are you Monsieur Fucker?
Honey. Listen to him. Belinda, you deserve that.
Yes.
Donnie, you deserve that. You know that?
Yeah, sure. That's what grown-ups say.
How old are you?
He looks to be about 7.
7? How did you know that? How did you know that, Mrs. Fucker? Stop it.
It's all right.
Donnie, please.
Because... I can tell your teeth have just grown in the front. You lose them when you're 6 and they come back in when you're 7. You've got grown-up teeth now. You're on the way to being a grown-up.
See that? We're on the way to being a grown-up.
Honey, how would you like to maybe come over for dinner?
Like to eat?
Can we do that, Belinda? Can we just take him home for dinner, and if it doesn't work out, bring him back later tonight?
Absolutely, of course, of course. Please, if it's not any undue stress. I don't want to cause any undue stress. No, it won't be any stress at all.
Come here, you. Come on. Follow us. You're coming with us, all right? Just for dinner. All right?
Just for dinner. Okay.
Then I get to do whatever I want.
Honey, if you want to come back, we'll bring you back.
Here's the keys. I'll meet you in a second, okay?
All right. Come with me, Donnie.
It's that way.
Okay.
Belinda, I just want to say this. I just want to say this is so great of you, honey.
I called you honey. I just called you honey.
Jesus Christ. Please. I just called you honey.
You can't do that, Gary. That's wrong.
I know it is. I didn't mean to do it. It just came out of my mouth, all right? Jesus. When's the last time you cut your hair, Belinda?
After we broke up, I vowed I would never cut it.
Donnie, why don't you get in the back seat?
Is that so wrong?
No, it's not wrong at all. I hope this isn't too awkward for you. I'm sorry, I didn't know who else to turn to.
Why would it be awkward that the man I love so much, he left me and a month later married, and has been married for a year, and then his wife, who has a week to live,
came all right,
here
all right, okay. I better go, Belinda. Thank you. I'll give you a call if we want to bring Donna back.
What? I never had the chance to give something back to you. Keep it here. I didn't know what to do with it.
It's the fortune from the fortune cookie of our first date.
Yes, the one I used to tape to my finger like a ring.
You've twisted it around metal, so yes. It's like a ring.
Yes, like I told you.
Sometimes things happen twice.
Like true love?
You giving this back to me? Why don't you keep it? You never know. Sometimes things come true a lot later than you think they will.
How do you know about my teeth? How come you know so much about teeth?
Well, I was a dental assistant for a while.
A dental assistant? What is that?
That's someone who helps a dentist.
No, it's not!
Yes, it is, Doc. Here, will you get the chairs, please?
Dentists don't need any help.
Yes, they do, because sometimes the patient is so afraid, so very afraid, that the dental assistant has to hold them down while they drill their teeth. And sometimes the patients are so afraid they die, and the dental assistant has to help them bury the patient.
Honey, isn't it true that some kinds of dental work are so painful they cut off somebody's head before they work on their teeth, and then they glue it on later after they're done?
That's done in Europe, yes.
What's Europe?
It's a place that's far away.
Like the moon?
Yes, like the moon, but not quite that far.
Donnie, you should wait to start eating until we sit down, too. Spit that out.
Donnie, I think what we're saying is your teeth don't look like they've been taken very good care of recently, and...
We'll have to take care of that. But not right now, and I'll be there with you, and nothing will happen. Now, let's eat our salad before I serve the spaghetti.
Spaghetti?
Yes, with mushrooms in it.
With mushrooms in it?
Yes. Now, let's eat our salad, and that cheese is blue.
Tom Sawyer came out of the cave, and the townspeople were all there and applauded him.
Okay, I think it's getting a little late.
What's applaud?
They're happy for him for
like
what he
clapping?
Did.
Like clapping? Because he was a brave boy. He got everyone out of danger. All right? Come on. Time to go to bed.
Let's tuck you in.
Go to bed?
Yes.
I have to go back home.
Not unless you want to.
What do you mean? I'm allowed to stay here tonight?
Mr. Davis and I would like you to be our little boy if you'd like.
You'll be Donnie Fucker.
I don't want to be Donnie Fucker.
Hey, I was kidding. Donnie. Hey, kid.
Gary. Go on, let me talk.
I was kidding.
What's kidding?
I'll tell him. Go on.
What's kidding?
Here. Go have your nightcap.
What's Europe? What's kidding?
Donnie. You wouldn't be Donnie Fucker.
I don't want to be.
Well, who would want to be?
I don't know. Someone who's dumb.
Yes. And that's the last thing you are, is dumb.
Yes.
You'd be Donnie Davis. Doesn't that sound nice? You're gonna get your feet out of
there?
Yeah.
I'd rather be that than a kid who's lesser than Fokker.
Well, you won't have to be that.
I don't have to be.
No. And tomorrow, I'll show you on the world globe where Europe is.
It's not a globe.
Yes, it's like the world, only smaller.
It's far away.
It is far away. But one day, if you want to go there when you grow up, you can go.
Well, can you go with me? Will you go with me?
We'll see.
Am I have good teeth?
Maybe. You're a good boy, you know that.
Now I do.
Donnie, there we go. Just come over here. All right. Twist that screwdriver one more time, and then that new headlight will be in there. Oh. All right, just twist it. It's almost tight. Go ahead. Remember what I showed you earlier?
Yeah.
Turn it that way. That's tight. Righty, tighty.
Okay.
Lefty, loosey.
You're nailing it right into my head.
Sorry. I'll help you. Here you go.
Okay. Like that?
Yep. Here. Now it's a new headlight. You fix it.
I know.
You broke it, you fix it.
I know. Who wants lemonade?
I do!
We do.
I'll bring it out to you.
Both of us.
We do, both of us do. All right, I'll bring it right out.
Okay, Mom.
All right, Donnie.
What'd you just call her? All right.
You can say it.
I called her my mom.
It's okay. Hi, Annie.
Hi.
We just fixed the headlight. Oh. Actually, I didn't do much. Donnie did most of it.
Well,
I did it most.
Congratulations. I'm very proud of you.
Thank you.
Let me put this on the hood of the car and I'll serve it.
I'm going to go wash my hands.
All right. Right through the window.
He and I will fix it.
I'm going to go.
It's all right.
It's all right. You're getting used to it.
Here are the drinks. I'm going to sit on the hood for a minute. Oh, my feet are tired. Sit down, honey. You hear what he just called you?
Yes, I did. He called me Mom. I can't tell you how much that means to me, Gary. And how much it'll mean to you when I'm gone. I have 6 days left. I'd like to use them wisely. I mean, maybe give or take a day, or who knows. But this means so much to me, and I'll always be indebted to Belinda. What was that thing she had on her finger? It looked like a piece of wire with a paper around it.
It was. It was a fortune and a fortune cookie from the first time she and I went out.
I thought it had something to do with you.
It did. She put it on a wire and wore it as a ring for a long time. She tried to give it back to me when we were at the... over at her place, but I didn't want to take it. I gave it back to her.
Why didn't you take it?
Because. I don't know why. That's because...
Well, it's neither here nor there.
I guess not.
We have lemonade. It's on the hood of the car.
Drink it. Here's to us. Here's to 6 days.
6 days of
great
family happiness.
Love isn't something that you gotta hold on to. Love is something that just comes along. Next thing you know, that what's most important to you is taken away, horribly taken away. See a little blood on the pillow. Go see a doctor and get some bad news. You gotta make what you can of that time.
I'm in the conversation pit down here in my office.
You're not in the loft?
No, I'm down here. You can come in. I'm not up there in the loft. I'm down here in the conversation pit.
Oh.
Hang on, let me shut the hot tub off.
All right.
Sorry. Mr. Davis, I didn't want to call you at home and tell you this, but looks like that rhinitis is most likely going to be pretty accelerated. Instead of 6 days, your wife probably could go at any minute. There. I hope that's direct enough for you.
It is, Doctor. There's nothing we can do.
Just prepare for anything. Just prepare for anything at all.
How do you do that? That's like not being prepared at all. Donnie!
Touché.
Donnie, come downstairs. Hurry before your father gets home. Otherwise, you won't be able to taste the frosting. He'll eat it all himself.
Oh.
Here's what's left on the spoon. Taste it.
Oh. Oh, that's good, good, Mom.
Don't forget the other side.
Oh, there's two sides. What are you doing, Mom?
Nothing. I just need a dish towel.
What? Why is there paint?
No, it's blood.
There's blood? No, it's not, Mom.
No, it is, Donnie. Donnie, your mother has to tell you something.
What? Does it spray blood on the ground?
No, it's real blood, Donnie. I didn't even think about this.
Think about what, Mom?
What you're going to feel.
Oh, God.
All I thought about was myself.
Like what?
Sit down next to your mother.
Are you going to show me the globe?
In a little while, I'll stop for a moment. Donnie?
Yeah, Mom? Is there more frosting? Do you need me to fix something I broke? Can we call someone and just say something and they'll say something back?
We can do that a little later, but right now, your mother has to keep a very serious conversation with you.
What's serious?
Donnie, I am very sick.
No, you're not, Mom. Because you make lemonade and you make cakes. And you read to me.
Yes, Belinda. I have my headset on. I told you. I'm driving safely. I'm just very upset.
Upset?
Yes, I told you what the doctor just told me.
Why are you calling me?
Because I just needed to talk to somebody, all right? Somebody who's not dying at any moment.
We're all dying.
I
know. Every moment.
Of course we are.
The moment we are born, we're dying.
All right.
Isn't that what they say?
Belinda, yes, of course. Those are just platitudes. My wife is dying.
I know, Gary.
I want to come by.
I
want to see you.
No.
I want to.
No, Gary.
Are you home?
Yes.
I'm coming by your apartment. I'm close to it now.
Don't come by.
Oh, please. I'm going to buzz you in a minute.
Don't buzz me.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Donnie. I'm very serious right now. I'm going to die.
Why, Mom? Why?
Because I have a nose disease. And it's going to make me die, I think, sooner than I thought. But I want you to know how much I love you, Donnie. Don't run away, please. Please don't go away. Because you'll still stay here with your father.
No, I don't want to. I want to be with you. I don't want to be with Mr. Fucker.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
No.
Are you saying no or yes?
No.
No.
You have the crazy, fuckingest entrance to an apartment of anybody I've ever met.
I always love that about your apartment, Belinda. Do you know that?
Gary, you think you're feeling what you're feeling, but you're not.
I am feeling what
no,
I'm feeling.
No, this is a stage of grief.
Belinda.
It's called delusion. It's one of the 8 stages of grief.
Belinda.
Brother, stop me! Don't let me do this! Brother, stop me! Let me!
style?
No, really, stop me, really.
All right.
I don't
want to... Answer your cell phone, Gary.
Answer your cell phone, Gary.
Hello?
Gary?
Yes?
I've started to bleed very severely. I don't think I'm going to be around much longer. I told Donnie I was dying and he ran away. I don't know if he's upstairs or in the yard, but I don't feel strong enough to run after him.
Do you want me to come straight home and take you to the hospital, or do you want me to look for Donnie?
I want you to do whatever you think is right.
All right,
but if you want to see me, I'd get home as quickly as possible.
Oh, Jesus, I have to get home. This is it. Donnie ran away. He's on the street somewhere. He's loose. She told him she's dying and he ran away. Come with me, Belinda, come. No, don't. Come with me. Come with me. All right. All right.
You go looking for Donnie. I'm going to go into the house quickly. Honey! Honey! Dear! Darling! Oh my God, the blood! You're losing so much blood through your nose.
Help me out.
Oh God.
Gary, I need to tell you something. I'm about to die, I can tell.
No.
Don't say that.
No, I'm going to tie a tourniquet around your nose. Is that?
Gary, you don't have much time.
Don't say that, honey. I'm gonna put my fingers farther up. This might hurt.
Gary, stop. I'll hold my own nose.
Gary, listen to me.
What?
Stop.
What? Donnie needs a mother. If Belinda and you want to get together. You have my blessing.
No, don't say that. No, I...
Let me see your face.
Hurry, let me see your face.
Move towards me.
She loves you, and I know you have feelings for her.
Don't say that. I don't have any feelings for her.
Yes, you do.
They're just old feelings. They're left over.
Sometimes, if you put your feelings in a microwave, leftovers can taste brand new.
That should be on a fortune cookie, you know that? Donnie, come here. Get over here!
Gary, go get the globe. Go get the world globe. Go get it. Do what I say.
Hold your mother up.
Go ahead.
Like Dad was good.
Like that? Like that, Dad? Donnie?
Hold her hard.
Honey, let me see you.
Like that?
Yes. One of these days...
Here's the globe, honey.
Bring it close. One of these days, you'll go here. This is Europe. And you'll go with your father and maybe a new mother. But you know what? I'll always be with you.
I don't want a new mother. I want you, Mom.
I'll always be there for you. I'll be inside of you. I'll live inside, and I'll always be there.
How can you live inside of me? You're bigger than me.
You're gonna get big someday.
And then we'll put Mom inside of me?
Yeah. Then you'll know she's inside you, okay? I love you both. Very much. And think of me when you go to the Eiffel Tower in Paris. I'll be there with you. I'll... I love...
Paris Orphanage, son. We talked to him like he wanted us. They need somebody there. They want you to start on Monday. It's called Lundi in French. Can you say that, Tom?
Lundi?
Yeah.
That's Monday, right?
Sure is. What are you looking at, Tommy? Donnie, I mean.
Just, maybe the light was catching the water on the Seine. That's all it was. I'm sure it was probably just the water on the...
Mom and I are gonna go down to the crepe place we passed, all right? Come down and join us.
When you're ready.
I'm sorry I called you Tommy, sport.
It's all right.
All right. Come on, honey. Let's go down the set, shall we?
I'm sorry.